Hey, good morning, YouTube. Old Slick here. How is everybody doing today? Man, fine, I hope. If you look over here, got a bunch of boxes. When I bought some parts for those street glides. But what I did this time, instead of buying original manufactured parts, I purchased aftermarket parts. Traditionally, I've always been a purist when it comes to these bikes and most of all my bikes. However, I decided this time to go with some aftermarket parts because I've been doing, if you look at some of my past videos, you see I'm doing a lot of stuff on dual sport bikes and I'm using a lot of aftermarket parts and they're working out great. So I decided to do that this time. And when I looked at what I paid for these and what I would have paid for original manufactured parts, I was astonished at how much money I saved, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start, this is not gonna be an unboxing video and it's not gonna be an installation video. I'll spare you that. But what we're gonna do, we're gonna take it out of the box. Once I get it out of the box, I'm gonna look at it, kind of check the quality of it. Then I'm going to go ahead and do the snap installation, have it on. Then we'll look at it on the bike, okay? I'm gonna start out, like I say, with the one that I've saved the least amount of money on. Then I'm gonna work my way up to the one that I saved the most amount of money on. Now, what I want you to do, you need to stay to the end of this video because the one that I saved the most amount of money on is a part that just about most, that I think most riders, it's one of the first things they put on their bike. Okay, it's the first thing that I put on, and I bought this part, original manufactured part, 5 times, because one time I lost one. I bought this 5 times, so I wish I'd known that then. And that's the only one that I've actually unboxed earlier because the price difference was so amazing that I could not believe it would be the same thing. Now, a disclaimer, some of these parts aren't exactly the same, but I think what I purchased is maybe even a little better than what it was. We'll talk about that as we go. Okay, so, hey, but before we get started on this, if you would please like and subscribe and help old Slick, man. I'm trying to get to 1,000 subscribers and I'm about 2/3 away there. Okay, sort of the way I plan on doing this, it's like I said, I'm starting with a part. After I get it unboxed, look at it, and after installation, I'm also going to show you a picture and the price of the original manufacturer price that I just pulled off the website like yesterday. I just took a photo of it. Then I'm gonna show you a picture of what I purchased, and it's actually from my Amazon account. It was like my receipt. And at the very end of the video, we're gonna go over the total, what the OEM total cost would be. Then it'll be the total cost of the aftermarket parts, and then make a comparison. Also, part of the disclaimer is all the original manufactured parts I've purchased before have always been really, really good. They were expensive. All right, man, let's get after it. Okay, for the first part, I'm actually changing out a part. Is I'm replacing this long antenna with a 7-inch antenna. Okay, there you go. That was a pretty easy installation. I literally just screwed it in. Okay, the reason I'm changed that out was it's just hard for me to put my cover on with that, and it's always poking me. I think that right there will be fine. Okay, the next part is mid-frame heat deflectors. Okay, what this part does is, like I say, it's a mid-frame heat deflector. It goes right here, and this power plant produces a lot of heat. And if you don't have this on, this heat will come, because your leg comes right across here, and it breaks some of the heat off your leg. I've had this on all my bikes, and it's almost a must down here in Mississippi. I'm gonna take this off and get this painted vivid. All right, let's make a price comparison. Okay, item number 3 is soft lowers. Let me show you what these things do. All right, what are soft lowers? That's what they are right there. I ride year round, and when it gets cold, there's a lot of wind coming on those slick, skinny legs, you hear me? So I like having these soft floors. Yeah. Now, these are kind of fancy. They got some reflective on the front. I like that. And they also have, looks like a zipper here. Pretty cool. And a pouch here. Old slick can hide something in there. Hide some money in there or something. All right. You need to buy. You need to borrow $5. I probably got one in there for you. Okay, so also they have dual zippers where you can put your highway picks. All right, let's make a price comparison. Okay, next item up is adjustable air deflectors. What are they, you say? I will put them on and I'll show you what they are. Okay, before I install these, I'm gonna show you kind of how this is set up. And a lot of wind comes off the side of this right here. And this is something I like that I'm fixing to put on now. I like it for the summer and the winter. And I can deflect wind off of me. And y'all also in the summer, you can move them like that and pull wind over across your body. All right, here's the deflectors. Here, this will turn in. And I think it really brings a good look to the body. All right. All right, let's compare the prices. Okay, next item is adjustable luggage rack. And folks, I'll tell you what, I've been dying to put this on. So I got all this stuff like last week. So let's see how it looks. Again, I'm gonna show you a little before, then we're gonna do the after. Okay, before I move on with this, I know this is not an installation video, but I'm gonna show you something I had a little trouble with. This piece right here on each side is where this clamps onto. Okay. It was too narrow. It wasn't, I was thinking, oh man, this is from here to here is too narrow. And I'm thinking, man, I gotta bend this thing. And I'm thinking my luck had ran out. But what I discovered is that piece right there is reversible. It's thicker. You see the right side? The right side is thicker than the left. So all I do is pull a screw out and reverse those, and it worked. It also comes with a little tool that helps you clamp that on. All right. Okay, there you go. Man, old slick likes that. This was a very easy install once I flipped these things around. Went on like butter. This thing weighs 5.5 pounds. So it's gotta be good. All right, let's compare that price on that rack and the one that I picked out. Now this is the one that probably is the least far apart. I could not find a rack, that an OEM rack that looked like this, that was this type. So the rack that I picked, I honestly believe this is probably, if this was an OEM part, I think it would be much more expensive than the one that I'm gonna show you, that we're gonna compare to. Now, the last item, this is the one I hope you've been waiting for. You're gonna be shocked at the difference in the price of this product. All right, the last item that I've been talking about, the highway engine guard pegs. Okay, you got the mounting bracket and the pegs, and they came with these tools. When I purchased this, this all came together, one price. Okay, there they are. I took the lowers off just so I get a better look, and it was easy to put them. But notice this. I would not have put foot pegs on here that didn't match. I am a little persnickety about that. Ladies and gentlemen, these, I have installed 5 sets of these. They're the same thing. They all come from somewhere, probably overseas or whatever, but they just package in different packages, you know what I'm saying? All right, that's the way they look with the soft lowers. Ooh, oh, slick. That looks good, son. Yeah. And I'm happy with that. All right, now let's go back and make price comparison. You're going to be shocked. Okay, as far as installing all that, everything was easy. Probably the hardest thing to install is going to be that piece that I didn't put on. And like I say, with that piece, I'm gonna send it out and get it painted the same color as the bike. And those, I really don't need those on until next summer. So, you know, that's no big deal now. Well, once I get it all on, I'll probably shoot it on another video. All right, it's probably what you've been waiting for. All of these products, had I purchased them, OEM parts. And like I say, now, a disclaimer, some things are a little different. You know, but I think probably some of these are maybe even a little better. But total price, don't know how close to $1,000, it would cost me $997.65. So $997.65, I think we can call that $1,000, right? All right, so about $1,000 for those six parts. For the aftermarket price, the total of all six of these were $250.90. So what I saved by going with aftermarket products instead of OEM parts was $726.75. And I believe everything on here is gonna hold up nice. Like I say, the big thing, those foot pegs, that is the sixth pair I've installed. So they're the same thing. And that's the huge one, man. For those foot pegs, OEM, I saved $274.91. No slick, then paid that five times. Boy, it seems like I'd learned something by now, but maybe I haven't. Got any comments? Hey, please send comments. Hey, please subscribe if I hadn't said that earlier. Trying to get to 1,000 viewers. Going to try to make this channel blow up, do some good stuff. If you want to request some videos for me to do with this or either on dual sport bike, camping, anything like that, send me a comment. Okay, anything that I've purchased, if you want to know what something is that I put on here, what the name of it, where I got it from, you know, what company out of Amazon or whatever, shoot me a comment and I will send you the information on it. Hey, if this video has helped anybody, I was glad to do it. And hey, man, that's what I want you to remember, man, especially during these times, be brave and courageous, not afraid and discouraged, because God is always with you. All right.